You just heard Woke Up This Morning. This is a song from the African-American tradition that originally had the words, "Woke up this morning with my mind stayed on Jesus." Now, the late Reverend Robert Westby of Aurora, Illinois, changed the lyrics from "stayed on Jesus" to "stayed on freedom" while he was imprisoned in Mississippi during the 1961 Freedom Rides. The song was used in this new form throughout the civil rights movement. Then the late Joseph Brewer arranged it for the Chicago Children's Choir, which is how I learned it by ear in 1971, and it stayed in my ears for 50 years until, with some help on the piano part from my friend Eric Charleston, I was able to write it all out, choir and piano, so that we could sing it for you today.
Joining together each Thursday this spring with the amazing singers in our Good Memories Choir has continued to be one of my very, very deepest joys. Caregivers, care receivers, and volunteers, thanks to each of you from the bottom of my heart for your continuing love for singing and your continuing love for each other. Each time we meet, without fail, at some point in the rehearsal or the coffee chat, someone bursts forth with an expression of gratitude. Grateful for the music we share together and for our continuing to grow together in fellowship and camaraderie. The spirit of gratitude simply permeates our times together for the joys we celebrate, for the problems we contemplate, and for the encouragement we give each other when we're feeling blue. For the happy birthdays and the holidays that we share together, that sense that we share that we are rooting for each other, not only in music, but in life. In each of the virtual choir videos you're enjoying today, we Good Memories singers get a special frame, staying close together on your screen as well. By joining us today as our virtual audience, we, in Good Memories, are now connected with you as we share with you our music and our hearts.
This is a program of songs on the theme of peace and justice. We're releasing this concert in May of 2021. It has been a difficult time in our country, and not only because we're more than a year into the COVID-19 pandemic. Justice is central to our American character, written into our Pledge of Allegiance, with liberty and justice for all. As the headlines of the last year keep showing us, these things are much easier to say than they are to accomplish. As choristers, we support each other to sing together as beautifully as we can and to deliver to you, with our voices, the emotions in our songs. It's time for us to do that again now. Here's another song from the 1960s made famous by the Byrds. It's timeless words from the book of Ecclesiastes. To everything there is a season. Turn, turn, turn. Arranged by Roger Emerson.
Please let me tell you a little bit about what we do during Ask Amy each Friday at 10 o'clock on Zoom. This is a Zoom session, and so we get to talk to each other and interact kind of the way we would in an in-person choir rehearsal, at least the closest we can get for now. It's been a joy and a highlight of my week, and from what I hear from all the singers, their week as well, to get to meet, go through the music, ask any questions, see what parts are hard. I get to know what parts choir members are struggling with, and then they get to see me sometimes struggle with those same parts too. I'm of course an alto, maybe even borderline tenor, and I'm mostly helping sopranos and altos, so it's hard for me as well. I also get to stay connected to the choir in this way, which I value greatly. Sounds Good overall has been nothing but a joy in my life since I started 5 years ago with Jonathan. And so I'm very happy to continue working on the same music that you're all doing and answering any questions that you have about it. We've come to know each other. The singers that usually join on a Friday are from all across the area, from Hyde Park, Evanston, downtown. We've even had other singers joining in from the East Coast. So it's really great to bring all those different areas together, geographical areas. And sometimes there's fun surprises. I think the biggest one in my memory was finding out that Linda Kaplan and Iris Rudnick are actually sisters. And all along they had been tuning in from different floors of the very same building, and nobody had any idea until they mentioned it in passing. So it's been a great little group to meet with every Friday, and of course it's open to everyone. So I hope to see you sometime at Ask Amy on a Friday morning at 10.
Hello everyone. Well, what's one of the first questions a singer wants to know about a program? What are we going to sing? That's really something that the conductors think about all the time. We are planning seasons far in advance of when they actually occur. We are always listening and looking for music for you. The most important component of any program is the music, and that is selected carefully. How does that happen? Early on, when Jonathan and I were the only conductors, we planned the programs together. Now, with several conductors and many individual ideas, we pool our recommendations and work as a team to see what makes the right combination for our next program. Each conductor can recommend their top several choices, and then we preview them before we actually get together. Currently, we are meeting by Zoom. Previously, it was a little more fun to actually be together in a space because we were able to sing some of our choices. We do like to sing too. There are many considerations in developing a program. We are starting with more pieces than we can actually perform, and we edit them down as we decide how these pieces are working together. Considerations are given to the key, the vocal ranges, accompaniment, possible instrumentation, the tempo, musical style, the level of difficulty, the duration, musical form, the arrangement, and the musical substance. There always needs to be pieces of music that we love and that we hope that our singers will love too. The bottom line, the choral music is what we select with great attention to the musical details. We've done our best to choose the highest level of repertoire for your programs. So now let's listen and enjoy what you've rehearsed and prepared for spring 2021. I can't wait to hear the next performances.
I've rotated the camera a little bit for this next introduction because it's a piece of classical music that you're about to hear now, and our dog Mosley happens to love music written for string orchestra. The German composer Felix Mendelssohn was active in the middle of the 19th century, and he inherited from his predecessors Bach and Handel music in a style called the oratorio, which is a large-scale work written on sacred texts, usually from scripture or adapted on verses from scripture, usually with soloists and an orchestra. So Handel's Messiah and Bach's St. Matthew Passion, for example, belong to this genre of oratorio. Mendelssohn decided to write an oratorio on the life of St. Paul, and so we're about to sing for you a movement arranged for choir and piano from that oratorio called St. Paul, and the lyric here has the refrain, "How lovely are the messengers that preach us the gospel of peace. Since this is a concert about peace and justice, we wanted to be sure to include this beautiful work. And it has three different voice parts, and they all overlap and come in at different times. This is called counterpoint. It's a really, really beautiful way of writing a piece of music, and has been a bit of a challenge for our singers, and they've really risen beautifully to that challenge. We have a good-sized group here also at the Sounds Good and Good Memories Choir, and lest you think that the large choir is only a recent phenomenon, you might be interested to know that in 1836, when Mendelssohn's oratorio St. Paul was first premiered in the city of Dusseldorf, there were 364 people in the choir. So we decided for this virtual production that we too would rent a large concert hall, which you're about to see now. Enjoy.
Friends, at the end of this session of Sounds Good, when we're celebrating the music that we've made, and I'm celebrating the accomplishments that you guys have achieved, not only learning the songs, but making your selfie videos and uploading them and dealing with technology and showing up every week to rehearsals. I want to commend you for hanging in there and for bringing so much joy to my life with your comments and your participation and your energy and your love for music and for each other and for the love you've shown to me. And I wanted to take a minute and recognize a small team of people that help me help you with rehearsal tracks and making videos. I'm surrounded here virtually by Leah Crane and Kristen Lelm and Sean Summer. I did a Zoom interview with them. It's about 15 minutes long, and we'll make that available to you if you want to see it, but it's too long to include in this program, so I just wanted you to see their faces. Leah Crane sings the soprano rehearsal tracks. Kristen Lelm sings the alto rehearsal tracks. I've been singing the bass and tenor rehearsal tracks, and Sean has been making the videos. I make a piano track with click, the same thing that you hear when you get the rehearsal tracks. I send them to Leah, who lives in Indianapolis. She's a professional studio singer. She sings them on her equipment and sends me back. She sings it three times, each part three times, sends it back to me. Kristen lives in Chicago. She does the same thing three times. I sing the tenor part three times, the bass part three times, so that it sounds like a little mini choir. Sean is the one who's been downloading and receiving your video files and turning them into these beautiful virtual performances that you're seeing. His process takes about 2 weeks. It's incredibly labor intensive, and he's put together a video explaining how he does that. But this is my team. I couldn't do it without them, so I wanted you to meet them.
After I have all your videos, I put them all together and line them up so everyone is in time with each other. I then take the audio from your video files and import it into a separate recording software. Then I go through each and every audio file and listen for any background noises that your mic might have picked up, and use another special software to remove that so all we hear is your voice. With so many recordings, this can really add up. So I can turn this into this. Once all extra noises have been removed, I group everyone by section. I carefully adjust the balance of each voice to create the virtual choir. Then we add in any extra instruments, and now we have our final mix. Back to the video editing software. Depending on the song, I either group you by section or by other factors that might make for a coherent group. Could be fun hats or Christmas trees. The final stage of video editing is kind of like choreographing a dance, trying to capture the emotion of the song visually.
Hello, singers. Congratulations on a wonderful session. Bravo for your hard work and commitment and diving into new things and being brave. I'm Mary Doughty Mauch. This is my office, classroom. I've taught the voice vocal technique and the sight singing classes here since last summer. And then in January, February, started rehearsals on Friday mornings from here. And I have to say, there's been some really wonderful surprises. And my singers made me cry last week. And that's true, but happy tears. I've been blown away by the in-depth concepts we can get into, the communication, the one-on-one, being able to communicate, ask questions, and actually feel like we're working together. That's been a wonderful thing and something I'm very, very grateful for. So congratulations. Hope to see you soon. Take care and have a great summer.
For a song of peace and a full-throated, open-hearted welcome, we turn now to a traditional Hebrew melody, Hevenu Shalom Aleichem. The word shalom has multiple meanings in Hebrew. You use it to indicate hello, goodbye, and to speak of peace. These three words, Hevenu Shalom Aleichem, mean we have come to say shalom to all of you. I don't know about you, but at whatever point I'll be able to hug everyone I love, this song will probably come to mind. It's joyous, and the melody travels around all the different four voice parts in this wonderful setting by David Eddleman. Enjoy, and shalom! Shalom.
Shalom Aleichem.
To close our program, we want to share with you another freedom song, We Shall Overcome. Composer Mark Hayes put this song together with an iconic song from 1972, The Beloved Lean on Me. Mark Hayes took the trouble to videotape an introduction to his song himself, and here he is.
Hello, this is Mark Hayes coming to you live from Kansas City, Missouri. And I want to say a big hello to the Sounds Good Choir and the Good Memories Choir. I think those are wonderful names. Your director, John, asked me to say just a few words about one of my arrangements that you were singing, Lean on Me with We Shall Overcome. I write music full time, and so I have these relationships with publishers and music editors at the publishers, and they often assign me, would you like to arrange this song? And so that's exactly what happened in this case. One of my music editors, a guy named Greg Gilpin, you may know that name because he's also a very fine composer. He is the choral editor at Shawnee Press Publishing. And he asked me if I'd like to arrange this. I can't remember if he suggested putting We Shall Overcome with this or that was my idea. But I thought the message of both of those just fit really, really well together about unity and brotherhood. As you probably know, We Shall Overcome is sung at a lot of civil rights marches, events in churches all over the United States. It actually has four listed in the credits. There's four different songwriters that are listed, but it was also influenced by the African-American gospel singing tradition. It was influenced by the Food and Tobacco Workers Union and the Southern Civil Rights Movement. So a lot of history packed into that song. So I was intrigued with putting those two songs together, and one is kind of a stately, poetic lyric to it. Lean on Me, that was written by Bill Withers, has the lyrics are kind of street language, the vernacular of the day, but it seems like they fit together pretty well. And then at the end, as you know, I've used part of the melody of We Shall Overcome, coming back in the coda section with the groove of Lean on Me still happening. So I hope you've enjoyed singing it. I hope you've leaned in on it, pardon my pun, and really enjoyed that soulful black gospel flavor to it. It's one of my favorite kinds of music. So I hope I get to hear your virtual recording. I'm not sure if you're doing this at a live concert or how it's being presented, but I know it will go well, and I wish you all the best. Mark Hayes, signing off.
Thanks so much, Mark. A timely reminder that we all need each other. Speaking of which, we couldn't do any of this without our amazing post-production team of Paul Langford and Sean Summer. Give it up for these fellas.
Woo-hoo! Great job, fellas! Woo-hoo!
Also, in this next song, you'll see and hear a tenor soloist at the end, and that's Mr. Paul Langford himself, an amazing singer and wonderful human being. Finally, we can't say enough good things about all of the singers who have brought their A-game every week for 15 weeks, all spring session long, to make this virtual choir a reality. Huge congratulations to everyone in our online choir.
And here they are.